So we're right back where we left off at after this terrible, terrible start. We didn't do bad. Well, we did, but yardage-wise, moving the ball wasn't horrible. Rushing game, there's a lot of upside there in terms of being able to rush the ball. Passing, definitely gonna need some work. I had more first downs. I don't know how actually. Punt return, yards return. Total yards gained, I dominated it. Now, turnovers, however, was a huge problem. I threw eight picks to one touchdown. And I also fumbled the ball once. Fumble, not my fault. Couple of the picks, not my fault. Most of them. I'll take credit for all but two. Oh, I hate playing with just bad quarterbacks because I make bad decisions. Just bad decision after poor decision after poor decision. I said bad the first time. I'm not sure why. But we're going to go to next week, see where the team lies. And so we get Ronnie McLeod back. We get Davion Taylor back. So a couple changes are going to be. We're going to go do this first. Deontay, yeah, he's not even playing. Let's put it to physical, make him a bit of a tougher receiver. All right, now we're going to go look at the team. So I can show you guys, because last video I wasn't able to. A couple issues happened. So we have Jalen Hurts, currently the starter, because Zach Wilson got hurt. That happened in preseason week one. Huge, huge, huge loss. Tutu Atwell is our second receiver. Fulgham's here. Greg Ward, Amon-Ra St. Brown there. I might want to trade one of these guys. Oof. I hate doing that, but I might need to trade one of my linemen just because they need so much money and we're not in a win now situation. And then defensive line, pretty good. Nothing really much changing. Darius Slay, Wandae Maddox. We got Caleb Farley there. And then him, how do you say that? Seymour? 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 Probably Seymour. He doesn't look too bad, just a little older. I put Kevon Wallace over a strong safety again to fill in while McLeod was hurt. And we have no strong safety, so he's actually our starter in general now. Bubba Bolden's our backup now because McLeod's back. We drafted, what's his first name? I can't remember. Shaka Tony. Okay, that's what I thought. I just didn't think that was right for some reason. But he's our starting left outside linebacker who I may move down to a left or right end later on. Once Brandon Graham retires, who do I want to trade him now and get Josh Sweat starting snaps? I do. I'm actually going to go and try and do a trade here. Who's going to be interested? Is there going to be any interest anywhere for Brandon Graham? All right, I'm not going to be able to trade Brandon Graham, which is fine. I don't really want to trade him anyway. I like him on the team, so no one wants him. That's not a problem at all. Just means we'll have to have Josh Sweat sit another year, and I'm sure he'll be back and playing next year. We have players returning from injury, which is good. So I think we can get into this game, and we should have a really good chance to actually win here. I think we'll be good. Be in a pretty good position. I don't know if I'm liking how quiet this stadium is. It's just so quiet. I don't know how I feel about that. Yeah, I'm not even gonna look at Jalen Hurts' stats. They were so bad. So bad. Don't want to talk about it. Don't want to talk about it. I don't know why I threw that at all. I actually have no idea. There you go. Maybe I just need to play on the linebacker a little more because Bubba Bolden's actually, he looks huge. I was clicking. Okay. Well, off to a wonderful start. Let's see if we can get open on the outside. Oh, blocks. Ah, come on. I was a little too fast for Jason Kelce to be able to get there on the outside and really, really hold down the outside lane for me and let me get around. But I kind of burst played that wrong. Like burst used the speed burst wrong. Oh, huge truck by Butler. Way to go. Fighting for every yard he can get. Wow. That was a good play. I honestly was a little worried because as soon as I threw it and he started running in, I got scared and thought it was going to be a pick. But he caught it and was able to make the guy miss, and he just got caught from behind. But that was a good play. It was good. Not much bad happened there. Oof. Miles was not going. Oh, that is not good. Now Brandon Brooks is hurt. Of course, that's what happens when I decide I want to talk about trading him. Now I'm not going to be allowed to because he's probably out for 3 weeks or something stupid. Ooh, huge block. There we go. There you go, Atwell. Whoa, go. Can I run in? There we go. Way to go. There we go. Trying to make up for some of the interceptions I've thrown. It's going to be nearly impossible. If I want a chance to get anything higher, like an MVP or something, I'd have to throw no interceptions for the rest of the year. That is unlikely. Because I've not thrown 9, and we're in the first quarter of the second. I just got to be way smarter with the football, and I'm just going to say that my last game was a bit of an adjustment to the new system, because I'm used to playing on Xbox with the old gen. This is the newer updated gen, and I haven't actually played on this before, so it's going to take a little bit of getting used to, and I know that on defense it's definitely going to take some time, so that's my excuse that I'm coming up with. And Melvin Gordon? Oh, they don't have Philip. I bet they don't have Philip Lindsay anymore. There's 3 of you there. Someone, do something. There we go. Way to fill the... Well, he filled the gap great. He just kind of got pushed for... To let him get 5. There's the draft class we went with. Definitely wasn't what I would have wanted it to be. And if the Eagles do that class in real life, I'd be so beyond angry. Oh, they did run it. I don't know why I didn't think they did. There you go. Big play Slay. Let's go. We get... Nope. That's where that was ending. What a play by Slay. Way to get up there and beat him. Beat him to it. That was an awesome, awesome play. Really what we needed to get back into this situation here, I think. Oh, wow. That just collapsed. I saw Ray Bumper open, but I didn't. They just got in so quick. Like, wasn't a whole lot I really could have done there. The defense is actually playing really, really well. And I'm really surprised and I'm impressed. Wow, well they've played. Okay, of course I just had to say something. I think I might have stopped them. I stopped them. The mic. 47's the mic. Good run, Miles. This play's not going to end well. I need that free safety to, or the strong safety to be pulled down a little bit for this play to really work. Can I get out to the outside there? I can. Just beat him. It's faster. I got a little scared there, thinking he might have fumbled, but we were able to escape it. Once I started rolling out left, I didn't trust to actually throw anything. Shoot. Just get rid of it. Play. I also need to change the subbing so that Miles Sanders isn't constantly exhausted. Because a play like this, I don't even want to go for him. I'm going to try this. If we get Atwell there, this is either going to end great or horrible. I'm just going to run it. Get the first. I better have gotten the first. Thank you. I'm going to run to the right. The right side looks a little less blocked, and I should have all 5 of those guys blocking someone. Nope. Didn't open up the way I wanted it to, so I didn't have a lane that I could follow. If we can get Atwell open there, that could be good. Huntley might even be able to run up to the outside there and get open by himself. Throw it. Wow. Good throw. It was inaccurate, but it was inaccurately well because it pulled Goddard to the outside and was able to get him to run for it and be open. I don't know if that made sense, but the way he threw it, even though it was an inaccurate pass, I think that was the most accurate it could have been purely because it was away from the defender. It pulled Goddard back and made it so it was an easier catch for him. Rather than having to fight through contact and catch it. Oh, that should have been a huge TFL, but I completely missed him. Completely just right past. Really screwed me up there. Ooh, huge hit. Way to go. I can't cover man coverage. I'm so bad at it. His change of direction is so bad. I can't turn something. Oh, screenplay. Got that smothered. I was all over Ingram. Right, Melvin. Melvin Ingram's his name, I think. I don't remember. Pretty sure that's what it is. Why can I not remember? Played for the Chargers for so long. Oh. Why is he so open out there? That's not even my zone. That's Darius Slay's job. Not even. That's the safety's job, and he was nowhere to be seen. I was covering one of the safety's jobs already. That's actually annoying. There you go, Goddard. Way to fight for it. Way to fight. Just because he fought for it so bad to get as many yards as he could, I'm going to call a timeout for him. See if we can get anything else. That was incredible effort. Incredible effort. Going 2-2. There you go. If I can get like 5 more yards, I can get a field goal. Do I want to just run the ball and try and get it? I think I'm just going to run the ball. Try and get some of the yardage here. And yeah. I think that's a pretty good play there. You're not risking much. You're pretty much guaranteed to get a couple yards. I probably just fucked it. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. I'm so bad at this. I'm so bad at kicking the ball. I'm so bad. Melvin Gordon, not Ingram. Don't. That's the defensive tackle or whatever. Defensive end, even. I think he's either defensive end or tackle. I'm pretty sure he's an end, though. He's a end rusher. Oh, they do stop Philip Lindsay. That's not my zone. It's man coverage. That's why I don't run man. My team isn't... The overalls aren't good enough to run anything else. So if I do zone, I can at least cut off 2-3 routes myself. Whereas with man, I can only... I have to follow one guy, and it limits. Ooh, huge hit. Fumble the ball. Give me one. Just one. Ooh, that was my fault. 100%. That's why I can't cover in man. I just got so exposed. There's nothing out there. Because a man, you can't cover your zone. You've got to do exactly what the receiver or tight end or whatever's doing. It's got to be almost perfect how the players are. And it was just such a sharp cut route. And I was already losing off the beginning because I got thrown off and wasn't quite paying as much attention. And there's nothing I could have done to recover. I just wasn't good enough is the reason there. Get open, thank you. Get up there, Kelsey. Good block. Run. Oh. You're joking. Come on. This team with its injuries. There you go. There you go. Breaking tackles, stumbling forward, gaining 12. Way to step up. I'm going to keep in him after he did that. I'd be okay with Miles not even coming back for this game. I'm sure I'm going to regret saying that here in a second, but the high point, he tried. The effort was there. He might not have come down with it inbounds anyway, but he at least prevented an interception, and the effort was there. Oh, no. Another long field goal. You know what happens on these? Perfect. Nope, not even close to perfect. And I'm going to push it right. Oh, it's going to be short. Yep. Can I even make it from that far? I don't think I can make it from that far out. God. I need to get Joey Sly so I can make those kicks. Oh, he threw it right to him. He threw it straight to him. I might even be able to get a pick six. No, not quite. There's too many people there. Great return, though. Good job, Farley. Right place, right time. Push in. Okay. I was going to try and move forward in the pocket, and it just wasn't happening. And Brandon Brooks is hurt again. Apparently, he came back. I don't even remember that. It's fourth down again. Let's see. I can miss my third field goal. This one, actually, that one's going to make it. So it's going to be 17-21. Pretty close game so far. Pretty good game even, too. I'm liking this. It's actually fun. It's not even high scoring. It's pretty average. 21-17, like, that's not a high score. Even if each team scores... Oh, broken ribs now. Yeah, that's going to be... I think that's 8 weeks, right? Oh. Yeah, I won't be able to trade him at all. Oof. Who did I switch me to? Some guy on the left. 3 touchdowns to 2 interceptions? Yikes. Fletcher can get in there. Good. Oh, my. Jesus. Thank God he tripped. He was in there so quick, and then Melvin Gordon just had none of that. I was blitzing the guy that guys that were covering there. Just not enough defenders. Found the weak spot. Oh, there we go. There we go, Rager. Off to the outside, and he's off to the races. Gets caught by Justin Simmons. Still a huge play. That's what we need from him. Speed, ability to run after the catch. Makes him so much of a threat. Sanders is able to run easily, untouched, to the end zone for his first touchdown of the game. Way to go. Great team plays. Just good play after good play. That's what that was. I'm just going to run it. It's all open. No reason to force anything. What? I'm pretty positive he stepped out of bounds. I'm actually like 90% positive he stepped out of bounds there. Did he step out of bounds? Yeah, because that makes so much sense. Okay. Get him, Graham. Get him, Cock. No. Nobody was able to get to him. I should have been able to with Brandon Graham, but I decided to try and dive so he couldn't throw it away, and that was not the move. Should have just kept running at him. Going Hargrave, able to get something? Nope, they're just going to run the ball. Get there. Easy yards. Ah. There you go. Oh, that is not roughing the passer. You can't call that. Oh my God. You can't call that. They're gonna run the ball, of course. I'll have to score before the 2 minute warning if I want a chance. If I want the best chance to win this game, I've gotta score before the 2 minute warning. Right, that's pass interference. First off, he's in front of him, slowing him down. This game, dude. I would have had him burnt if the guy wasn't in front, which I get that's what you're supposed to do in that situation. But oh my God, are they gonna count that as a catch? Because if so, that's the greatest catch of all time. They're not going to. What an effort. And, of course, the camera's going to be so broken, I can't even watch it. Here you go, Rager. Probably should have gotten out of bounds with that. But, oh, well. Can't now. Just going to run with it, get out of bounds, take some yards. That's a... I That would be roughing, but okay. I don't know how that isn't intentional grounding, but okay. I might have it turned off. I hope I don't have it turned off. Because that would screw a lot of things up. Oh, a lot of open space. Tons of green grass. Oh, wow. What a play by Fogel. There you go. Huge catch to put us right back in it. We just got to make a quick stop and we've got a chance. You did not just do that. Come on. He's going to run for a touchdown. Oh, come on. This game. Oh, my God. I can't call timeouts. I'm going to try and save my timeouts. That's what I'm going to have to do. Come on. I don't know what I can do here. There's really not a whole lot. Don't let it be picked. And it's tipped three times. I don't know what I'm supposed to do there. Nothing is the answer. They're just going to knee the ball out. That's going to be the game. Score obviously lost. Passing yards. And everything else was actually pretty similar. It was a pretty close game. Really close game up until the fourth quarter. And it was just a shootout. And whoever really came up on top, and they did. They were able to pull ahead, throwing for four touchdowns and two picks, and I threw for two and two. 18 of 30 versus 25 of 31. Not much he can really do. Melvin Gordon just destroyed us. It was really the big thing, and he had two touchdowns. Miles Sanders had 19 rushes for 85 yards. Receiving Noah Fant also. He destroyed. So did Jerry Judd. Apparently Jerry Jeudy had 7 receptions for under 4 yards. Don't really know when that happened, but did. Tutu Atwell, 5 for 78. Goddard had a few. Rager had 3 huge catches. Huntley had a couple. Fulgham had 2. One of them was huge. A huge touchdown catch that put us right back in it, and we just weren't able to come back. Wasn't anything we could have done. We did what we could. Defense. A lot of tackles from Beckwith. Brandon McLeod had a bunch. Shakatoni was actually pretty. I saw his name a few times. TFLs, we had one. We had one sack from Fletcher. One pick from Farley. One from Darius Slay. Kareem Jackson and Bryce Callahan both had one as well. No forced fumbles. No blocks. No safeties. No touchdowns. And I also missed 3 field goals. Nope, I missed 2 field goals. Right, field goal, yeah, I missed 2 field goals, which we would have been able to win, right? That would have put us, that's 35, 38, that would have been a 4-point game. Well, it was still a really good game overall. I had fun. That's what matters, as long as I'm having fun, right? If I can enjoy it, I know you guys can enjoy it. As long as I edit it and make it fun to watch. Not like last video. Last video was so bad. I feel so horrible even posting it. It was that level of bad. We're going to give Miles more looser. We'll get him a little bit more agile. Yeah, 3 juke move. Jalen Hurts needs everything. I'm gonna go 1 into strong arm and try and get up throw power a little bit. Just to help him. Nope, there's throw under pressure and throw at mid. It's not what we want. He's actually not doing... He didn't do bad that game. The previous game was horrible. That game was pretty good. It was really good. Zach Wilson's injured and he's getting upgrade points. I'm going to put one in improviser for him. Get up some of these stats. Plus 2 break sack, plus 1 throw at mid. Throw on the run is huge. Throw under pressure is also big. On the run there, 79. It's under pressure, 76. He gets some of these stats up. Not too great. Trucking, yeah, he can't truck anybody. What's his speed? 78. I'd like for him to be a little faster, but I can manage that. How fast is Jalen Hurts? One new injury. It's going to be Brandon Graham, who's 6 weeks. Yeah. He has Zach Wilson back next week, which will be a huge, huge thing. But yeah. That's a team. I'm actually going to simulate two next week. And then we'll get some of that stuff done. Might as well. What was I going to look at? I don't even remember. I came in here to look at something. I don't know what it was. I have no idea. Oh, Jalen Hurts speed. 87 speed. So that's going to be a huge downgrade in terms of speed. Because I like to be able to run the ball with a quarterback in. I'm probably not going to be able to do that much with Zach Wilson. It's going to be something I'm going to have to get a little used to. It's going to be a little tough. Going to be a little tough. And our offensive line obviously takes a bit of a hit there with Brandon Brooks being hurt. And I almost want to move Atwell to my wide receiver one, but he's doing good at wide receiver two, and he's putting up good numbers. So I think I'm just going to leave him there. Fulgham putting up, doing some good numbers too. I'm actually going to look at stats. I know it's only week two, but I want to look at my team stats. It says first in the NFL, but that's because I've played both my games. Oh, that is bad. We're not even going to look at that, actually. Rushing, we've got almost 200 rush yards, 4.8 per attempt. We got 10.3 per attempt with Hurts. We had a touchdown with him, too. Receiving, Tutu Atwell is up to 150 yards. Rager is one shy of 100. Miles Sanders is 15 shy of 100 there. Our running backs are third best receiver. That's a little scary. Fulgham's not doing too bad. I'm happy with how this team is going. We've already got some sacks, three of them. Nothing great, but they're there. They exist. And we've already got three interceptions, which is, at this point, at least half of what you'd get if you just simmed through the entire season. Missed three field goals on the year already. Yikes. My passer rating is so bad. I'm first in terms of defensive yards. And I played a game already. Points allowed 30th. Yikes. Offensive yard is I'm 17th. And people haven't played. Defensive yard, I don't know how I'm first. Yeesh. I guess because I held the 49ers to only like 150 yards or something like that. But we're going to see next week. See what's going on here. Hopefully we'll get Zach Wilson back so we can use him. Yep, Zach Wilson is back. Who do we have to sign? Chase and Kelsey. That's going to be interesting. Dallas Goddard's also going to be interesting. How much money do we have to work with? Oh, I am not used to seeing the Eagles having cap room. That is a beautiful sight. Wow. Oh. There's a lot of people in here. I'm actually going to have to re-sign. So I want to bring back... Jordan Mailata's got to come back. He has to. Beckwith might actually be coming back. He's not doing bad. And he could develop. Jarrett Avery's gone. Travis Fulgham, probably gone. Josh Sweat, probably going to go. Unless I sign him to a one-year deal. Derek Barnett... Same thing. Probably going to go unless it's signed to a one-year deal. There's not players I need on this team. And actually, I might sign Barnett to a three-year just to fill in that position for a few years so I can find someone that I like a little better. Ronnie McLeod's gone. He's a little too old. Avante Maddox, definitely need to re-sign him. I like how he's played so far. He hasn't given up too much from what I've seen. Like what I've actually seen him do. Brandon Graham, got to go. He's too old. I hate saying that though as an Eagles fan. I might bring him back just cause. Just let him retire as an Eagle. But it'd be a cheaper 1 year than that. I'd give him 11, not 12.9. Dallas Goedert, I think, has to come back with his potential. Jason Kelsey, same thing as with Brandon Graham. I don't know if I want him on the team, but because I love him, what he's done for the Eagles. I might just bring him back. And he's a good person to really hold down the line and keep everyone together. Kind of it pulls everything as one rather than it kind of everyone working individually. really pulls everyone to work as a team. Jeffrey Allen, early first rounder. Wow, he looks incredible. B minus all across the board. Interesting. Oh, well, he sucks. He's also bad. He's also not great. Another good corner? What is happening? Interesting. This draft class is gonna be interesting. Sean Bradley gets an upgrade point. He needs to improve as a pass cover guy. I'm not really worried about a run, because our front four should be able to stop him if I can build it the way I like him built. Josh Sweat needs to be a good edge rusher. I want him to be able to really get to the passer on the edge there. I think that's everyone. I think that's it. Turning from injury, Zach Wilson, as I've said. I think I said that once, but we're going to look at here. Zach Wilson, starter, right away. Also, specialist. I need to change. What does I need to change? Nope. Special teams, not specialist. I needed to put Amon-Ra St. Brown back up there, because I want him to be my returner instead. But liking everything else here. It's starting to come together a little bit. Ty Edwards there. I'm actually going to start Davian Taylor over Ty Edwards. I think I like his potential a little better. I think he can develop into someone who can at least hold the position for a few years for me, until I find someone I really want to put there. Hopefully this offseason I can get a really strong middle linebacker to hold captain and manage this defense for me. But as of right now, it's Fletcher Cox and Darius Slay holding down the fort, and Brandon Graham, but he's getting older. He's almost at the end of his road. I wish that's not the case, because he's just such a great player, but it's the truth. Andre Dillard, actually, you know what? I'm going to try and get something for him. Anyone interested? I'm actually still a little negative in cap space. No one's interested, as figured. Andre Dillard might even just be getting cut entirely off this team. I just don't like him. Another one of those guys that was drafted in the first round by the Eagles who hasn't become anything. It hasn't played well. Has not played well. Well, thanks for sticking around and watching me get beat again. But hopefully in week 3 we'll be able to turn it around, beat a division rival, and maybe take first. Maybe. Depending on how it goes. How the division's going. Actually, take a quick peek here. Points for. I need to score a lot of points to take first, I think. It's going to come down to division. What's the division? They already have a. Nope, they don't have any division win. Nope, they have one. They have one division win already. So Cowboys actually stay on top. Even if I do win and they lose. But I have a feeling the Giants will probably win too, because that's how Madden goes. So, next week, hopefully we can flip things around and try and win some games. I need to win at least 6. This is what I made my goal. I want to win 6 games this year, because that's what I think I can do. Yikes. These players are bad. These players. Ooh. Maybe we look to try and get one of these guys next game, or next video. I can try and make a trade for someone. If anyone wants me to do that, just let me know. And I'll see what I can do. See what I can do. Michael Onwenu? Why is he there? Maybe that's someone I go for. Because if the Patriots don't want him, maybe he can play for us and fill in for some gaps we've got. I wouldn't be opposed to that. Would not. not be opposed to that at all. I'm just kind of going through so we can see what's here. I think that's the big guy I'd want is Onwenu. Everyone else is kind of meh, I guess you'd say. Like, okay, but nothing better than what I've already got. Tavon Young? Interesting. I don't need corners, though. Julian Blackman's here. Why? I don't get it. Jordan Fuller? I could get a free safety, better free safety than Bubba Bolden. He's played a good linebacker. Maybe that's what I do. I could move Bubba Bolden down to a linebacker position. I could bring Malcolm Jenkins back. That'd be an interesting story. Julian Love, Eric Reed. Lonnie Johnson Jr. Some interesting names in here. Why are there kickers on the trade block? Weird. He has a lot of kick power, though. Signed for aging. He's on a practice squad then. Never mind. All right. We'll see what we can do. Maybe we bring some of those guys in. Maybe we don't. We stick with what we have. Let me know what you guys think. And I'll catch you next time. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to like and subscribe if you enjoyed and want to see more of the series. And yeah, peace.